Hi, I'm Fernando Pires, developer of the Audiosigma card ESP, and I would like to introduce it to you. Well, the signal processor is installed between the audio source and the power amps. So it receives unprocessed audio, and by utilizing digital signal processing, it applies many improvements and corrections according to the acoustics of your car and, of course, your personal touches. So it finally outputs processed audio to the amps that drive the speakers. By utilizing 56-bit double-precision digital filters and full-time alignment correction, vastly superior sound quality is achieved. Because it does only audio processing, you can always keep the factory head unit of your car. It constantly evaluates the voltage of your vehicle's battery and will put the volume down or even shut down your audio system if the battery voltage drops too low, so you don't have to worry about ending up with a dead battery. Also, it features independent RMS limiters for each output that will protect your speakers from damaging even if you crank the volume all the way up or if you're caught by surprise by a song that is louder than the other. It is very cost-effective because by utilizing it, you don't need other equipment such as EQs, crossovers, RCA converters, etc. But in the end, it all goes down to one question. Does it sound good? Well, let's take a look inside. The Analog Devices DSPs and the Texas Instruments op-amps offers audiophile sound quality. Also, the high output drive capability ensures that the audio won't lose quality by passing through the cabling, even if your RCA cables aren't that great. A fully regulated internal power supply provides high voltage to the op-amps, which allows for wide dynamic range and excellent transient response. Plus, the music won't stop even when you're cranking the engine. Now, to find out how it works and discover its features, let's install and configure it together. Here is a typical configuration that works great for many cars and SUVs and greatly benefits from using the Audiosigma processor. We have two-way component speakers at the front, coaxial speakers at the rear, and in the trunk, the subwoofer. The audio source can be the original head unit of your car by utilizing the high-level input, which already features auto remote, so you don't have to worry about the remote wire. Or it may as well be an aftermarket head unit by utilizing the RCA inputs and the remote wire. And you can even use an iPod or equivalent music player by utilizing the auxiliary input jack. The inputs of the amplifiers are directly connected to the outputs of the processor. In this practical example, subwoofer goes to channel 1, the coaxial speakers to channel number 2, the mid-bass speakers of the component set to channel number 3, and lastly, the tweeters of the component set to channel number 4. The remote of the amplifiers must be connected to the remote outputs of the processor, never directly to the head unit. Finally, we must provide the power supply to the processor, and the positive must come directly from the vehicle's battery. Please download the latest version of the software at audiosigma.com and install it first. Then, you finally connect the USB cable and you're ready to go. The software is very powerful, but yet simple to use. To begin, connect to the processor. Now you can select the type of transducer that is assigned to each output channel. I'll first open the frequency response graph, so you can actually see the frequency range that each transducer will be reproducing. Now, for this practical example, we have on channel 1 the subwoofer, on channel 2, the coaxial speakers. On channel 3, the mid-bass speakers. And on channel 4, the tweeters. By selecting the type of transducer, the software automatically configures the crossovers in a fail-safe fashion, as you can see here. You can leave as it is or explore the wide range of options that the crossover system offers. You can choose between Linkowitz Riley, Bessel, and Butterworth topologies, as well as slopes ranging from 12 up to 48 decibels per octave. Each topology and slope combination has different gain and phase properties. Feel free to experiment what sounds best in your system. The crossover is extremely precise. You can set the frequencies in steps of 1 Hz, as well as type in the exact frequency that you like. For example, most tweeters are good to operate from 2.5 kHz and up, so I'll just go ahead and set the mid-bass tweeter crossover point to 2560 Hz. Now, we are almost 50% done, so you can save the current configurations to a memory preset. At this moment, it is safe to increase the volume, and you might set the levels of each transducer according to your musical taste.
Standing open, security was laid back and laughed. It was only my heart.
One of the biggest advantages of having this processor is that you can perform the time alignment correction of your sound system. It means that the sound generated from each transducer will reach you all at the same time, regardless of the distances that they are placed in your car. But hey, why is that so important? Because your brain is an incredible machine. For example, when you drop something on the floor, you immediately know its position, whether that is in front of you, at the left, or the right side. That happens because your brain has the amazing capability to calculate the difference of time and amplitude that the sound took to arrive at the left and the right ears. Naturally, the same happens with music. Inside the car, the speakers of the driver's side are closer than the speakers of the passenger side. You also have speakers at the rear doors and the subwoofer in the trunk. Because of that, the sound stage becomes undefined. The time alignment correction fixes that, and the sound stage becomes perfectly focused, creating a much sharper and realistic image of the sound, like you would have in an ideal concert hall. To accomplish this important correction, all you have to do is open the time alignment and balance calculator and fill in these fields with the distances from each transducer to your sitting position found in the car. Okay, so let's imagine that these distances are 1.5 meters for the subwoofer, 1 meter for the left rear coaxial, 1.25 meters for the right rear coaxial, 85 centimeters for the left front mid-bass, 1.15 meters for the right front mid-bass, 70 centimeters for the left front tweeter, 95 centimeters for the right front tweeter. Now just click Calculate, and it will automatically apply the perfect amount of delay and balance compensation for each output channel. Now you can close it, and observe that these calculated values were applied here at the main window. Each RMS limiter features threshold control, which is the level that it will start to limit the signal, attack control, which is how fast it will limit the signal, and decay, which is how fast it will release the signal. Basically, what you want is to set the threshold level low enough so you can't hear distortion even with the volume all the way up. You can leave attack and decay as it is, or experiment with it to get best results in terms of music dynamics and speaker protection. To exemplify, let's set the limiter of the coaxial speakers. First, you will hear distortion as the volume is way too high, but after setting the limiter, you will notice that the distortion will be gone, fully protecting your speakers regardless of the volume level. The final step to get the best audio quality out of your sound system is to fine-tune it using the equalizer. It allows you to compensate for undesired resonances that are caused by the materials and the geometry of the cabin, as well as imperfections of the transducer's frequency response. The Audiosigma processor is particularly good at that because you can shape the response of the EQs like no other processor, being perfect for personal tune-ups as well as accurate acoustic correction. It has up to 96 bands, each one being configurable as parametric, high shelving or low shelving. You have independent equalizers for all four stereo output channels. You can freely choose the number of EQ bands that you would like to have per channel, and the software automatically calculates the center frequency and bandwidth of each EQ band in respect to the frequency range elected on the crossover. You can also separately equalize left and right sides of the stereo channel, so effectively, the signal processor features 8 fully independent equalizer modules. When configured as parametric, you can move the center frequency around as you please. You can also increase and decrease the bandwidth for a broader or narrower actuation. When configured as high or low shelving, it creates an ear candy ramp that actuates on high or low frequencies, and just like the parametric, you can always move the center frequency around. Now, how about we use a little of these capabilities in our practical example? Before I proceed, please be aware that this is an imaginary application to exemplify the usage of the signal processor. The adjustments will vary according to your vehicle, installation, and components used. Having that in mind, let's begin by equalizing the subwoofer to enhance the deep bass and kill some of the unpleasant cabin resonances that often happens. I am choosing 4 EQ bands because it is just enough. However, given the selected crossover topologies, I could open up to 18 EQ bands. I personally like deep bass, the kind that you feel more than you hear, and don't interfere with the musicality. Of course, this is just an example. You can always optimize it to your preferred purpose. As you can observe the decay of this frequency response, there is a 40 dB per octave, 20 Hz subsonic filter protecting the subwoofer from excessive excursion, so we are safe to push it hard without breaking it. Let's start by killing the cabin resonance that happens around 60 to 80 Hz. Now, let's boost the frequencies from 40 Hz and below. Maybe the vocals are lacking a little bit in terms of presence, so we can give it a little boost by selecting a central frequency with a wide bandwidth. Because of the reflections inside this particular imaginary car, there is a high-pitched ringing sound coming from the tweeters. Let's take care of that too. At this point, your sound system should be top-notch in terms of sound quality. But what happens when you're enjoying yourself listening to music while the engine is off? With the Audiosigma processor, it is entirely up to you to decide. The main battery, and optionally an auxiliary battery, can be monitored by the processor and it will filter out instant variations that normally occur when you crank the engine the AC kicks in, or even when the music demands more power from your system. The first thing you want to do is let the software know what is the power source of each of the amplifiers, whether it is the main battery or the auxiliary battery. As we only have the main battery on this practical example, I'll just leave it as it is. The Audiosigma processor can take action automatically to spare your battery, even when you're not looking. And of course, these actions can be previously programmed by you. Here, we choose what happens when the battery voltage drops a little. In this case, I'll select gain minus 3 decibels, so the volume is gently lowered and I know it's time to start the engine. Now here, we program what happens when the battery voltage drops more. The default setting is to shut down all the power amps, which is fine by me because if I forget to start the engine, it will protect my battery. When you have more than one power amplifier, especially if they are high power ones, it is always a good idea to turn them on one at a time, sequentially with a time space. That will spare your vehicle's electrical system from a huge inrush current that the amps need to start, preserving your alternator, regulator, battery, and of course, avoiding electrical problems. In this example, I have only two power amps that are connected to remote A1 and remote A2, so I'll set a delay of 1 second to turn on the second power amplifier. However, as you can see, there are a total of 8 individual remote outputs. You can set the desired delay time to switch on up to 8 power amplifiers individually. Well, we are all done. Now just save the configurations.
So, we finished this practical example by configuring the crossover, the time alignment, the RMS limiters, and the equalizers. Also, what happens when the battery level is low, what happens when the battery level is very low, and a little delay to power one amplifier at a time. But still, there's something very interesting we can do with this processor. Check it out!
Just like the audio settings, every power management configuration that you see on this screen can be saved to a preset. Consequently, when opening a preset, both audio processing and power management settings are loaded all together. For example, you can add different personalities to your sound system by choosing which power amplifier will be on and which power amplifier will be off, and of course, you can always customize the audio processing settings for each case. You may define preset 1 for high fidelity type of sound reproduction that is great to listen to jazz and go to work every day, so EQ settings are more or less flat and you have only one subwoofer working to complement the bass in a conservative fashion. But then, you can define preset 2 for SPL type of sound reproduction with bass emphasis, so it gives a boost on the low frequencies and switches on extra power amps to drive extra subwoofers. When you alternate between these two presets, the Audiosigma processor will reconfigure the entire audio processing and automatically power on or off the amplifiers accordingly. That allows you to, in a matter of seconds, completely transform your hi-fi sound system into a bass-shaking beast, and of course, vice versa. To put it in a perspective, to accomplish that without the Audiosigma processor, you would have to manually flip switches to choose which power amplifiers to use.
I sincerely hope that you liked this video and it could give you a glimpse of the benefits that the Audiosigma processor offers. If you would like to see pictures of the development process of this processor, please visit our fan page at facebook.com/audiosigma. If you would like to learn more about it, please visit our official website at audiosigma.com. And if you have any questions, I'll be more than happy to answer. Just email me at fernando@audiosigma.com. Thank you for watching!